Hello there, welcome to the new lecture. After the end of this tutorial, you would be able to understand the working of two-pipe FCU. So, let's start. First, we'll understand how the process of heating takes place in two-pipe FCU. So, this is an FCU, and because we are talking about heating, so there is a heating coil installed in this FCU. So this is the inlet of the coil and this is the outlet. Just near to the outlet, a three-way mixing valve is installed. Now what is this? This is a valve that has an opening at this section and at this section. Here it is named as A. If you look closely, you'll find that the name mentioned over here is A. At this end, it is mentioned as B, and this end is mentioned as AB. Now, how this works? This is the motor actuator of this valve. This basically gives the order and controls the flow happening through this valve. Let's say, in any case, the inlet is from side A and the outlet is from side AB. In this case, the B section of this valve is closed. So the flow is taking place across the section A and AB. It is also possible that if inlet is taking place from B, the outlet will be from AB and the section A is blocked. So in either of the cases, you will find that one of the section of A or B is closed and flow is set up across the other two sections such as A and AB or B and AB. Alright, now let's move ahead and understand this FCU further. So this is the complete piping near to the coil section. Afterwards, we have a piping arrangement like this. At first, it is very daunting to understand this because of its complex piping nature. But in few minutes from now, you will realize that it is very easy to understand. Over here, these are the three-way valves installed in specific locations. This is a water chiller. As of now, simply understand that a chiller is a device or a machine that delivers chilled water, and this is a boiler. A boiler is a machine that delivers hot water from it. This is a pump which is installed near to the chiller. So this is known as chiller pump, and this is a pump installed near to the boiler. So this is known as boiler pump. Now let's see how the functioning is taking place. We are now talking about the heating process, so there is no role of chiller as of now, only the boiler will work. When the system requires heating, the boiler pump will start to function and then the hot water from the boiler will flow through the pump into the heating coil. Once the hot water goes into the coil, the air flowing across it absorbs this heat and they become hot, thereby reducing the temperature of the hot water, and when it comes out of the cooling coil, it becomes cold. The air that is flowing inside the FCU is now hot. This hot air will be moved by fan into the conditioned space. The hot water is now cooled down when it passes through the coil and comes out from the coil. As it comes out, it faces this three-way reversing valve. At this point of time, the left section, which is the section B, is blocked. So the flow is taking place across the section A and AB. Once this water reaches another three-way mixing valve, in this case, section B is closed, and again flow is taking across the section A and AB. And then this cold water flows into the boiler, which again processes it and then heats it up, which is again then delivered by the pump into the fan coil unit. This is how heating takes place in case of two-pipe FCU. Note that there is a thermostat installed near to this valve. When the operation starts, let's say the temperature was around 70 degrees Fahrenheit and the requirement is to achieve 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Once the desirable temperature is achieved, this three-way mixing valve will shut off the end A. Once the end A is shut off, after receiving the desired temperature, there will not be any flow setup in this portion of the pipe. You can understand this from this diagram that once the desirable temperature is achieved, this section of the pipe will be blocked, and hence the water in this part of the pipe cannot flow. So the water that is coming into the fan coil unit will now move through this path. Now we know the section B is open because section A is closed. So now water will flow through this in this direction, followed by this pipe, and this water will now be hot because it has not been moving into the coil and increasing the temperature of air. So when we require heating, the section B of the valve will be closed and section A and AB will be functional. Once the desired temperature is achieved, section A of the valve will shut off, and now the three-way mixing valve will operate between section A and AB. So this is how two-pipe FCU works whenever heating is required. Alright, now we'll understand how the process of cooling takes place in two-pipe FCU. For this example, we are taking the temperature of the room to be 75 degrees Fahrenheit, and let's say the desirable temperature over here is 70 degrees Fahrenheit. The sensor will sense this temperature and actuates the valve in such a way that the section B of the valve is closed and section A and AB is open. Now, since we require cooling, so the chilled water pump will operate, and the chilled water will be supplied from the chiller into the FCU. Once this water is flowing through the coil, it will absorb the heat of the air flowing through it, and the fan will distribute this cooled air into the conditioned space. As the water flows through the coil, its temperature is increased, and this hot water will now be flowing through the pipe system back into the chiller to be cooled again. When the actuator senses the desirable temperature of 70 degrees Fahrenheit is achieved, in this case, it will shut off the section A and open the section B. When the section A is shut off, then no more flow can take place in this portion. So the water that is coming will not go this side now. Instead, it will flow in this manner. So this is how cooling can be achieved using a two-pipe FCU system. Now let's discuss the schematic of FCU. This is the schematic of two-pipe FCU. Because we have already understood the functioning of FCU for cooling and heating, so now it's very easy to understand the schematic, so we'll just quickly go through over it. Here we have the chiller, and there we have the valves over here. So from here, cold water will be moving out in this direction, and then it'll go through the FCU, then heat it, and then again flow back to the chiller. In the same way, water will flow to other FCUs and flow back to the chiller, and so on. Now suppose heating is required, so in such cases boiler will operate. So hot water from the boiler will flow through the pump and valve to the FCU. Then it gets cooled after crossing FCU, and then finally it goes back to the boiler again. In the same way for other FCU, from boiler, through pump and through valve, water will flow to the other FCU, cool down, and again back to the boiler. So this is how the schematic looks like for two-pipe FCU. Now for four-pipe FCU, the understanding is more or less the same, because whatever we have understood in the earlier sections, the four-pipe FCU system works on the same way, it just the addition of another coil. So whatever process is taking place earlier, same process will now take place together in different pipes. So let's say cooling is required, so the chiller will give cold water and then this cold water will flow through FCU, then gets heated up and then again back to the chiller. In the same way, for another FCU, cold water through pump, then to the FCU, heated up and then again back to the chiller. Now let's say cooling is required, so hot water from the boiler will flow through the pump into the FCU and then back to the boiler. In the same way, water will flow to other FCUs and heating or cooling can be accomplished. Okay, so now you know about working of two-pipe FCU. Hope you enjoyed this session. See you back soon in the next one.